America's attempt to follow the example of the Arab Spring.
The bankster's fraud continues now with bonuses obscene. America, America, how Wall Street shat on thee.
Social media had been abuzz with this planned occupation of Wall Street for months.
What do we want?
Revolution!
When do we want it?
Now!
Up to 20,000 people were supposed to spill out onto the streets of the Big Apple's financial district.
Congress need us, let's go!
But not more than 1,000 of the most fed up Americans showed up.
I've got my sleeping bag and my pad. I'm told not to bring a tent, so I left that at home.
Ben flew in from out of state to camp out here day and night. He has a simple message for the U.S. president.
He's just backed out of everything he promised in the campaign, so it's like he's asking to lose the next election.
Wall Street greed and corruption and the lack of accountability that followed brought these Americans to the brink.
This is just the beginning of occupying Wall Street. These crowds say they're going to be here until their demands are heard inside the offices of the Wall Street skyscrapers.
Over 46 million people are living in poverty in the U.S., with 14 million unemployed. Much of this triggered by the shameless gambling of Wall Street CEOs.
This very spot, Wall Street, is the site of a heinous crime. It's been perpetrated by Wall Street bankers who, instead of guarding people's money, speculated with reckless abandon and incompetence. And they clipped the wings of the American dream.
You get these corporations that are paying no tax. I pay more tax than GE and Exxon.
I spent a lot of years and a lot of money working very hard to get a degree. That degree is worthless now. And right now, ultimately, they are more powerful than any emperor has ever been. We are facing down an army of Caesars. And Caesar must fall.
I believe that we will win.
Mayor Bloomberg has been warning New Yorkers that as youth unemployment skyrockets, riots could be around the corner. But these people blame him, too.
Everyday people want to be involved in politics, and we deserve to be involved in politics. And I don't think you should have to be a billionaire like Michael Bloomberg to be involved in politics. You know, Michael Bloomberg is a beautiful example of what's wrong with this country.
But for demonstrations like this one to become a real force and not just a fringe group, more Americans will need to join these crowds.
I expect the volume to get a little larger. You know, all movements start off small. So to answer your question is why there's so few people, it's like, again, the information that gets out is controlled by the mainstream media, the corporate media.
So will the political and financial elite push Americans into launching their own Arab Spring, or will they take note before the crowds swell out of control?
One sucky, warmongering bastards!
Anastasia Churkina, RT, New York.